Kickoff in a moment. Second half kickoff, Florida State kicking to Pitt with Rendina kicking along the sideline, coming down deep at the 10-yard line. Compton at the 15, out to the 20-yard line. Barry Compton, wide receiver, flanker spot, takes it out to the 20 where Pitt will take over. First down and 10 yards to go. Panthers lead the Seminoles 21-7. There again, you see a graphic of the first half statistics, and ironically, the difference in the football game thus far has been the rushing edge that Pitt has gotten in the total yardage, 158 to 197. Each team even had three turnovers, but as John Steigerwald was mentioning, Pitt has been able to take advantage better of those turnovers and opportunities than have the Florida State Seminoles. First down and 10 yards to go, Pitt at their own 20-yard line. Marino giving off to Wayne DeBartolo, the fullback, hit along the line of scrimmage, and he'll get a yard out to the 21-yard line before they whistle it down. Second down, 9 yards to go. Gary Futch, Jarvis Corsi, and outside linebacker Ken Rowe screened that play out on what was an off-tackle play that DeBartolo took outside. Rushing-wise, Whiting and Williams for Florida State each was 17 yards. Brian Thomas, the leading rusher in the game, with 64 yards. DeBartolo has been helped out of 9 yards and 5 carries, and he is Pitt's leading rusher. Second and 9 with Marino to throw. Over the middle, it is caught at the 35-yard line and good for a first down by Dwight Collins. Collins making his second reception of the football game. That'll be first down and 10, Pitt. Again, you see that they're using DeBartolo as a safety valve. You saw him swing out, but this time Collins was wide open, hitting the seam between Ashley and Clayton. So first down, 10 yards to go for the Panthers. They're on 35-yard line. They lead 21-7, first possession of the second half. Marino throwing deep, man wide open, Dawkins got it. 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Pittsburgh. Julius Dawkins with his 8th touchdown catch of the year. A 65-yard touchdown bomb. John, it's been there all day with both Dawkins and Collins. This time, Marino was on the money.
And I get the feeling that they've been watching Collins awfully closely. Maybe he's laying off of Dawkins just a little bit. They may have talked about that at halftime because Collins only had the one catch in the first half. But Dawkins just beat his man. He was wide open. And Marino just laid it in there perfectly.
Eric Riley, the man embarrassed on the play, could do little but get a hand on Dawkins to the 5-yard line. Everett with a kick. It is up, and it is good. So Pitt strikes quickly. An 80-yard drive. The key play, a 65-yard touchdown pass from Marino to Dawkins. Marino's second of the game, is 15th of the season. And now, with 14-11 to play in the third quarter, Pitt now leading 28-7. Back deep to accept the kick from Schubert. 4 yards deep in the end zone. Here he comes. 15, 20, out across the 20 near the 22-yard line. Pitt has done a good job on the kickoff return team. And Florida State will now start for their own 22. Well, this is exactly what Bobby Bowden didn't want to happen. 3 yards, 80 plays, bang. A touchdown, 49-second drive. Bowden figures if he gets the ball, after holding Pitt, even a field goal puts him within 2 scores. Now he's 3 touchdowns behind, and he's going with Blair Williams to get a quarterback. High backfield. First down, 10 yards to go. Play fake. Williams looking deep himself. Got a man wide open at the 50-yard line and is dropped. Out of bounds. Phil Williams, leading receiver on this team, with 9 receptions coming into the football game. Cannot hold on to the football, it'll go incomplete. And one thing we have seen, or have not seen, I should say, Dennis McKinnon has been the leading receiver going into this game with 19 receptions. He's not caught a pass.
And that, you talk about being wide open. Williams was wide open on that play. The ball was underthrown. He never did have a chance. If you thought that he caught it, and then dropped it, he didn't. It bounced into his arms, and he still didn't hold on to it. Would have trapped it if he would have held on to it anyway.
Williams came on, leading Florida State to their only touchdown of the game. Here's a blitz. Williams is hit, spins away, hit again, fumbles the football, rolling loose the 15-yard line, and Pitt has recovered the fumble. J.C. Pelosi, the middle guard, recovered the fumble by Blair Williams, who was hit twice. Chris Dolman making the hit, and Pitt now really in the driver's seat.
There it is again. Williams with a big rush by Kranach. That's what started it. He got away and then just simply dropped the ball, and Pelosi was there to pick it up. And this Pitt defense is just unbelievable. They have so much quickness at every position. The linebackers are quick. The defensive ends and the defensive inside men on the line are quick. The tackles, unbelievable.
Pitch wide. Brian Thomas in trouble, hit in the backfield and dropped for a loss. Back to the 18-yard line, a loss of a couple. It'll be second down and 12 yards to go.
It's hard to compare, Stan, but you saw a lot of the Pitt defense last year. I don't think that the defense last year could possibly be any better than the team that's out there right now. And we've said it a couple of times here, but the amazing thing is that there's, one senior out there, two seniors.
Happy Thomas, the cornerback, and Sunseri, one of the linebackers.
It's supposed to be a rebuilding year, for the defense especially.
Well, if they're rebuilding, they're using good materials. Draw play, Thomas again, hit at the line of scrimmage and gets back to the line of scrimmage for no gain. It'll be third down and 12. James Gilbert reading the play very nicely, sliding along as he's supposed to do, making the tackle on Brian Thomas, making it third down and 12.
Here's the replay. Just a deep handoff, and it just took a little bit too long to develop, and the blocks weren't held long enough, and a good penetration there, and no gain. Thomas comes off and gets a new jersey. They do use the tearaway jerseys here, and some coaches don't like to use them for that reason right there. Sometimes it takes your number one running back out of the game for a play.
Third and 12 from the 18. Marino rolling to his left. He fires, and it is caught by John Brown. 5. Touchdown, Julius Dawkins. Pass to Julius Dawkins, coming across, open, and Marino bought enough time to find him, and Dawkins with his second touchdown catch of the game, third for Marino, and the game is out of hand.
Okay, when Dan Marino was recruited at Pitt, he was a high school All-American, parade All-American, so was Julius Dawkins, and I don't remember right now who came first, but I think Marino was recruited first, and when they brought Dawkins in, it would have been now 3 years ago. It was all the talk about what a great combination it would turn out to be. And this is really the first year that it has, because this is the first year that Dawkins has been given a chance to play. And there's the extra point by Everett, which is good, and it's now 35-7.
18-yard touchdown pass from Dan Marino to Julius Dawkins. That is Marino's 16th touchdown pass of the season, and that is an all-time single-season Pitt record. And we are only in the fifth game of Pitt season. So he'll top that by a large margin.
And I have a feeling that we haven't seen the last of the scoring in this game, necessarily by either side, but especially by Pitt. And you got to wonder what people around the country are going to think when they see that Pitt has been able to do what they've done so far here after Florida State came into Columbus and beat Ohio State, went into South Bend and beat Notre Dame, and they came in here, and they're getting just totally blown out of here.
Well, as we mentioned in the pregame show, Pitt's schedule from here on in really is kind of a piece of a cake. Syracuse, Rutgers, Temple, Army,
Boston College,
and of course the tough game will be Penn State. Penn State undefeated, ranked one notch ahead. Many people feel it's entirely possible that both could be undefeated when they meet here at Pitt Stadium on November 28th. And the major bowls may be put into a position of having to make a deal.
Winner goes one way and
loser goes another.
But they could both end up in a major bowl, both Pitt and Penn State.
Entirely possible, although, of course, Penn State still has Alabama. They still have Notre Dame. And in Miami of Florida, a very tough team. But I don't know that anybody, even the most ardent of Pitt fans, John, would have expected the score to be 35-7 with 12:33 to go in the third quarter.
Unbelievable. And you got to wonder what the bowl scouts are thinking. Even if Pitt should lose a game down the road, it's a good show to watch.
Schubert's kickoff coming to Allen, 2 yards deep. Tries to get outside. Flag down, gets out to the 16. But there was a flag on the play thrown in the middle of the pack, and that made March Florida State back a bit more.
Pitt is just playing with so much enthusiasm, even on the kickoff team, and with a 35-7 lead, they're running down there like maniacs. It's a face mask penalty. It's going to cost Pitt 15.
This will be Florida State's longest game of the second half.
You got to figure that when it was 21-7 at halftime, Bobby Bowden, as you mentioned, had to be in there saying, okay, we got to hold him on that first series. We get a touchdown, we're right back in the game. 3 plays later, it's 28-7, and then all of a sudden it's 35-7, and Florida State, if they don't give up, you got to give them a lot of credit, because most teams would at this point.
Pitt has scored 2 touchdowns in 2 minutes and 32 seconds of the third quarter. Coming right out of the gate, got movement on the offensive line, but no flag. Left defensive tackle move. Off to the inside. Coming out across the 30 to the 34-yard line. Greg Allen, who returned the kickoff, called a gain of after the penalty of about 4 yards, second down and 6 yards to go. Bowden's got to kind of tuck in his horns just a bit here to at least get his team calmed down. Obviously, they're shell-shocked. And there may be some eyebrows raised, obviously, by the score, but when they ask the question, is Pitt really that good?
Well, they've been asking it now. This is the fifth week, and I think the answer is yes.
Williams crossing pattern. We're going to have interference, and we should. We won't. It's incomplete. Phil Williams, the intended receiver, wanted interference on Pappy Thomas. He will not get it. That brings up third down and six.
He still wants it, and he's obviously not going to get it. I think you have to answer that question yes, Dan, because this team came in here proving, Florida State did, that they're a good team. And they won at Columbus, and they won at South Bend. Now, Ohio State and Notre Dame are big names, and maybe they're not the greatest teams that those two schools have had in a long time, but what they've done here is just amazing.
Here's the quarterback giving off to Allen once again, and it's kind of that fake Statue of Liberty, and he's going to be about a half yard shy of that first down. Ken Burnett, the ball carrier on the play, reserve fullback behind Whiting, and he's going to be short. Fourth down and a foot. Florida State has had its decision to make before, but I believe they've got to go for it. You're down 28 points.
Yeah, it's out of hand, but they're not going to do it. They're going to punt the ball away. An interesting thing here is that what is Bobby Bowden doing? Is he saying to his starters that they didn't do the job, or is he saying the game's over and we may as well get some of these young guys a chance to play, because he's got new people in there, and he's either given up or decided that he's showing the first team guys that they didn't do the job today.
Fourth down and a foot, watch for a fake. They've done that before. Stark gets it away, and it's a driving spiral. Flynn back at his 11-yard line, over his head and into the end zone. And that is a 61-yard kick.
Like nothing, like it was nothing.
Like it was nothing. That was a howitzer, a 61-yard kick by Ron Stark. All that's left for him is the pad of statistics. Pitt will take over gladly at their own 20-yard line. I mean, the one thing that could get Florida State back in the game is a fumbled punt, that sort of thing. They're just happy to let the thing go.
A miracle was going to get them back in the game, because the way Pitt's moving the ball, there's no reason to believe that they're finished scoring yet. And the way college football is set up today, where you got to get votes to decide who's number one, you can't blame any coach for scoring as many points as he can. If Pitt could get 50 points, that would impress a lot of voters around the country.
A little bit of a hesitation. Marino throws the bomb again. It is up, and it is incomplete. Intended for Julius Dawkins at the 35-yard line. This time, Florida State had the play well covered. Cornerback James Harris, number 33, had the play covered all the way. Incomplete. Pass really did not have a chance to be completed unless Dawkins could outjump the man for the ball. So it's second down and 10.
It also had a chance to be intercepted, but Dawkins made a good play to come back and prevent the interception.
Well, if you had any question about Pitt sitting on things, no, they're not going to do that. Marino now, 11 out of 21, 200 yards. He's thrown for 3 touchdowns. He's been picked off twice. Give to the tailback, Joe McCall. Guard. Thomas got room, 45, 50. He's hit from behind and dropped at the 35-yard line. The flag on the play. We may have a face mask against Florida State. Tracy Ashley finally caught Brian Thomas from behind, but not before he picks up yardage down to the Florida State 35.
It's a great move by Thomas. You'll see it. He comes through the line through a big hole, but here's the move right there. He really changed direction and just totally faked out the man who came up to make the play. And there's the face mask penalty, definitely.
Jimbo Covert, a great job of blocking left offensive tackle.
They found themselves a tailback. They thought they found him last week. They know they found him this week.
First down and 10 yards to go. Pitt now at the Florida State 21-yard line. High backfield. Give inside to DeFartola. He's got a hole. 15, down to the 10. Fumbles the football. Rolling loose, and I believe Florida State has it. They do.
Well, there was a time when you would think that a fumble in the third quarter would have been a big turnover. It's not now. There it is again.
Alfonso Carriker recovers on the play. DeBartola had a nice hole in here.
Yep, they're opening the holes up, this time off the right side behind Sams and Frelick, and the ball just pops up. And a scramble for it, and Florida State recovers the ball. Alphonse Carriker. Somebody's hurt.
And we've got a man down on the play. One of the things that Pitt has done so well, and they have ran the ball, very well against Florida State. Pitt offensive guards and interior linemen just eating up those linebackers. Those linebackers are playing 4 or 5 yards off the line of scrimmage. The Florida State scheme of things is to keep those offensive people off the linebackers. In the Oklahoma defense, which Pitt uses also, they front five, they have to keep the offensive linemen off the linebackers, but they are not doing that, allowing the guards to get at those linebackers and taking care of them.
Now, Pitt's just done everything they've had to do. Well-balanced offense. They've run the ball well, and Marino has had a good day throwing. There was a lot of questions coming in about his arm. He answered that 3 minutes into the game. That was no problem.
Williams in motion. Williams again, the quarterback. Ricky Williams hit in the backfield and dropped at the 3-yard line. Chris Goldman, who has played an excellent football game this afternoon from defensive end, came in, and Pitt now just coming in and making great penetration in the backfield, drops him for a loss all the way back to the 4-yard line.
Just quickness here, 6'6", 260, and he's back there before, almost as he got the handoff to make the play. He read it perfectly, and Florida State's been trying to run wide quite a bit today, and all they've been doing is running into either Dolman or Woods. The ends have been playing well and containing and boxing the ends, and the quickness is just, they haven't been able to overcome it.
Second down, 16 yards to go. Williams again, got some room now to the 10, out to the 15 and the 20. 25, hit and dropped outside the 30, near the 31-yard line. So a 17-yard game. However, there is a flag down on the field back at the 5-yard line. Offside, Florida State will come back.
And we've been talking about it. That play there was a quick opener, a delay, and it picked up some good yardage. None of the going wide. That's what they did to Pitt last year against the same type defense that Pitt had, different personnel, but same scheme, I would think. And they haven't done it much today.
And they did it well in the first quarter, then kind of gotten away. Of course, now you're down 28 points. Here's a give to Williams. Got room again if he gets another block to the 10 and out to the 15-yard line. It'll be a gain of 13 yards, but it still brings up third down and long yardage. Tim Lewis, right cornerback, came up to make the play on Ricky Williams.
Oh, it was again a quick opening play, and the hole opened quickly, and Pitt is so quick that if you take a long time, they're gonna come after you, a lot of people. But this is a play that develops quickly. It's a simple off-tackle play, and good pickup for Williams.
Good play by Tim Lewis, the cornerback who made the initial hit. 12 carries, 18 yards. Third down, 7 yards to go for the first down. Florida State at their own 14-yard line. Blitz on again. This time they pick it up. Williams now looks over the middle, and it is caught up at the 28-yard line. Good for a first down, and it is caught by Tony Johnson, who makes the reception, and Williams completes it for the first down.
Okay, give the quarterback, Williams, Blair Williams, a lot of credit on this one. He's eventually going to be chased out and to the left. They do a good job of picking up the blitz, but he's moving the other way and throwing across the field and gets a lot of zip on the ball. It was a little bit behind the receiver, but he was able to make the play, Tony Johnson.
His third catch for a heck of an average. Florida State's only been to the end zone once. First down and 10. Florida State at their own 27. Williams with a very deep drop, fires over the middle, man wide open, and is caught at midfield and into Pitt territory by Phil Williams. So Florida State beginning to open up just a bit, picking up that first down, good for 24 yards, and the first at the Pitt 49-yard line, but 7:58 to play, third quarter, Pitt on top, 35-7.
Here it is again, and just running a simple post pattern. He has time, he's looking at him all the way. May have gotten him in man-to-man coverage there. He got behind Michael Woods, who's a stand-up defensive end, but in some cases plays as a linebacker. He may have been isolated on him and got behind him.
He's going to see a kid like Woods, who is not big for defensive end, but still a defensive end that far deep in pass coverage. Williams blitzed and hit and dropped. Coming in was Chris Dolman. Who else? And Williams tried to duck to avoid it. I'm not so sure that Dolman hit him that hard. He just kind of ducked and fell down. And once again, Pitt coming from all angles and all directions. Dolman playing the same type position defensive end that Hugh Green played last year.
No chance here. Fake pitch, quick drop, set up. And that's a quickly developing play. It just shows you how fast Dolman got in there, because he only was back about two steps and already Dolman was rushing him and he had no chance.
Loss of 6, second down, 16 yards to go. Blitz on again. Williams throws in a flat, incomplete. Attended for Phil Williams from Blair Williams. Incomplete. coverage on the play. Dan Short. Third down, 16 yards to go.
And when the team's up 35-7, as Pitt is, you think, well, so if they score another touchdown, that's okay. I think that the Pitt defense, number one, they are number one in the country. They want to maintain that, so they're very interested in statistics. They don't want to see a yard gain. They're not conceding anything. If they get up 65-7, they won't.
Slot to the right on third down and 16 yards to go. Once again, Pitt blitzes, picks up, fires over the middle. It is intercepted and dropped, and a flag on the play. We may have pass interference. Pass was thrown behind the receiver. Troy Hill, number 22, you see there, had an opportunity for the interception, dropped it, but he may get yellow flagged here. Sam Childers, the tight end, pass interference, and that'll give Florida State a first down, the second time in the ball game that they have been called for pass interference.
Let's look at it again, see if we can tell if it was a good call or not. Well, it's hard to see from that angle. It was close coverage, and he must have bumped him on the way in, or maybe put an arm in front there before the ball got there.
Again, Pitt this afternoon going to a great deal of nickelback, and that nickelback is Troy Hill. So with the pass interference penalty, it gives Florida State a first down at the Pitt 41-yard line. 35-7, 6:47 to play in the third quarter. Give to Whiting, got some room, the 30, inside the 30 and down to the 27-yard line. Michael Whiting, the fullback, the senior, picks up 12 yards and a first down.
He had 71 yards last week against Notre Dame on 15 carries.
Quarterbacks Lewis and Thomas making the play.
And this is just another wide sweep, and this time it works a lot better than it has all day. He gets outside the defensive front five, and now the linebackers and the cornerbacks come up to make the play. So he picked up probably his biggest gain of the day. I would think that's his longest gain of the day.
Good job blocking by Ricky Williams, who took out linebacker Kranach to pave the way. First down and 10 at the 27. Williams to throw. Rush on, hit. He fires over the middle, wide open at the 5-yard line. Once again, it is Phil Williams who makes the reception at the 5. It'll be first down and goal. And a good job by Blair Williams, who had thrown only 5 or 8 passes this year. Doing a good job. First down and goal at the 5.
He's looked very good on this series, and he gets in the little trouble there and steps up and keeps his composure, throws a bullet over the middle. And Phil Williams did a good job of getting open. So now it's on the 5-yard line. But Blair Williams, the quarterback, as Stan said, was 4 for 8 for the season coming into this game. He's playing against the number one defense in the country and had a very good job considering all those factors.
Dave Pizzoli was the man who put the pressure on him. First down and goal from the 5. Williams to throw in the end zone. Touchdown to Childers. 5-yard touchdown pass. Blair Williams to Sam Childers. And the Seminoles are on the board. That'll make it 35-13. So a drive by Florida State, aided somewhat by a pass interference call, and they are on the board.
That's another nice play by Blair Williams, and a good call. Childress just coming from tight end on a quick slant. It's tough to, very tough play to cover, and a very good call, I think, when you're in that situation, 5 or 6 yards out. There's the extra point there.
Rendina with a kick. And so we've got 5 minutes and 47 seconds to play in the third quarter. And the score, Pitt 35.
And here's the touchdown, just a quick slant over the middle. And Childers is wide open.
Now we'll tell you, we'll finish what we started to say anyway. Pitt, 5:41 to play. Pitt leading Florida State 35-14. Rendina will kick off for Florida State. Pitt in a normal kickoff return alignment, no suspect, at least at this time, of an onside kick. Tim Lewis, the deep man, the trip safeties, and Rendina kicks it away, coming deep into the end zone to Compton, 3 yards deep. He'll come out. Wedge in front to the 20, gets away from one man, but does not make it to the 20, about the 19-yard line, matching his number, Barry Compton, and Pitt will take over at their own 19. First down, 10 yards to go.
Now, it's not over yet. I mean, it is over, but it isn't. It's 35-14. Quick turnover now. Pitt's on the 19, and a quick touchdown by Florida State. You still have almost a quarter and a half left and only a 2-touchdown difference, but I don't think Pitt should get too conservative here, because they can move the ball, I think, when they want to, so there's no reason for them to stop now. Florida State's got to get the turnover.
Here's a give inside to Brian Thomas. Looks for a hole and gets out across the 25-yard line to the 27-yard line. A good trap inside. Jarvis Corsi finally made the stop, but Brian Thomas adding up that yardage. He had 107 on that play. Picks up seven more. That'll make it 114.
Thomas is only 5'10", about 185 pounds, but he runs a lot bigger than that, and he gives a good second effort there and gets some extra yardage. He's done that all day. There's his stats, 8 yards a carry. You got to be doing something right.
Second down and three. High backfield. And again, it's Thomas. Hit at the line of scrimmage and is stopped for no game. Looked like a hole there, but James Gilbert, the nose guard, who has played a good football game today, came in and made the tackle when it looked like Thomas would easily have the first down. That'll be third down and three.
Here it is. Watch Gilbert close up the hole here. There, he just did a good job of fighting off the block. I think it was Boris, or was it Paul Dunn? Paul Dunn was on him, and Gilbert fought off the block and made the tackle.
Third down and three. Slot to the right side. Tight end John Brown in the slot. Collins flanked to the right and Dawkins to the left. So Marino will throw for it on third and three. Over the middle. It is caught by Brown at the 40. 45 and up to the 47. And it'll be a first down for the Panthers. And John, it seems that on third down, the Panther conversion rate has been excellent. And they've really been able to do whatever they wanted to do when they wanted to do it.
It's a good catch, but watch this throw. Marino is an overhand thrower, but he throws this almost sidearm. Three-quarter motion, a little bit stiff. The ball was well thrown and was a hard-thrown ball, and Brown did a good job to hold on to it. Coming across the middle, he was not really all that open. It was a good pass and a good catch.
And again, you've got a defensive end on him, Jarvis Corsi, who drops off. Someone charges offside. It was Gilbert, the nose guard. But once again, you have that defensive end covering a tight end or a back coming out, and Pitt has taken advantage. Marino now 12 out of 22, 230 yards, three touchdowns. He's been intercepted twice. Both those, however, came in the first half. Illegal procedure against Paul Dunn, who was in there for the injured Ron Sams. It'll be first down and 15 yards to go. So Pitt going on the kind of ball position drive they wanted. They had Pitt third down and three, and who knows, they score a touchdown before the third quarter's out. It's 35-21 and maybe a ball game. Here comes a reverse. Gift is White Collins. They smell it out. Hit by James Gilbert, who was not fooled for more than a half second. And he drops Collins for a loss way back inside the 35 and down at the 32-yard line. Again, Gilbert making a smart play.
Dwight Collins is a preseason All-American, and they're trying to get him into the game today, and they've had a little problem. He's only caught two passes. They've been for big gains. But here it was perfectly read by Gilbert, and a deep reverse going to cost Pitt a lot of yardage.
Scott McClain also in there on Gilbert. So the loss is substantial all the way from the 46 back to the 32, a 14-yard loss, second down and 24 yards to go. Three wide receivers, rush on, Marino with a screen, DeBartolo to the 30, 35, 40, and out across the 40 to the 41-yard line. So he got 9 yards on the play, a little more than a third of what he needed. It'll bring up third down, still long yardage, 15 yards to go. And while Pitt has not been throwing the ball downfield necessarily, against South Carolina a couple of weeks ago, Pitt had a 42-7 lead, and then late in the fourth quarter, all of a sudden, it was 42-28.
Yeah, and I think Jackie Sherrill is fairly well aware of that, and he's obviously told his offense that he wants some more points. He's not playing it conservatively and worrying too much about turnovers. He's throwing the ball upfield a little bit.
Another third down, this time 15 yards to go. Pass in the flat, caught at the 45, 46-yard line, but that'll be well shy of that first down. Brian Thomas makes the reception. He's got a good day coming out of the backfield, both running and receiving passes, and Pitt will be forced to punt.
That was conservative.
Hepler to punt. Cedric Jones inside his 20. Hepler gets it away. He gets off a skyrocketing punt. Jones takes it at his 8. Doubles back, tries to get outside. Nothing but blue. Loses 2 yards on the return, all the way back to the 6-yard line. And while there's been a great deal of hoopla about Ron Stark, and indeed he has not disappointed anybody with his punting, Dave Hepler, perhaps feeling the challenge of punting against the best, gets off a great punt there.
What may have cost Pitt the national championship last year is their punting game. They had a terrible night punting against Florida State last year in Tallahassee. And Hepler is a walk-on, and he's done pretty well in comparison to the guy they call possibly the greatest punter in college football history, if not the best. He's right up there with Ray Guy and a couple other guys you want to name.
And Tony McNally, who snaps on punts, made the tackle. That's called hustling.
It was great coverage on that punt.
First down and 10. Williams. Here's the halfback pass again from Allen. Got a man open, and it is incomplete. almost intercepted, and we've got a flag down on the play. Happy Thomas almost made the interception. The question is, which way does the interference go?
Well, from the immediate reaction, looked like Pitt was thinking it was offensive interference. Look at Pappy Thomas. I don't think he likes the call. I thought that it was interference on Thomas. I thought I saw some shoving, I should say. Maybe I should wait to see the replay. Let's look at it. The halfback pass, and amazingly enough, the receiver is wide open again. It's a nice jump pass here. I don't know. I didn't see any problem there with what Thomas did.
He may have pushed a bit, John, before the ball got there.
You see Tom Flynn pointing right away to the receiver as if to say, that, yeah, good call. That was offensive interference. Didn't go that way for Pitt, so Florida State gets out of the hole.
Well, you can tell how much the local fans like the call. First down and 10. Give to Whiting. Gets across the 40-yard line and out to the 41 for a gain of 2. It'll be second down and 8 yards to go. And again, Pitt has strung out the wide plays very nicely. That time, Rich Kranak made the play.
Rich Kranak's played a good game. And linebacker, he comes up and makes the play here. Whiting tries to jump over the top. Kranak stays in there and submarines him.
And again, the difference in play, John, both teams using the same defensive schemes. The Pitt front five has been able to keep the Florida State blockers off the linebackers, and the linebackers in the Oklahoma defense should make 70% of the tackles. Second down and 8 from the 41. Play fake. Williams screen pass. Allen with the reception, but not much room out to the 43-44-yard line. Gain of 3. It'll still be third down and 6. Kranak again, smelling screen coming up, making the tackle.
Somebody smelled screen because there was nobody in there really pressuring the quarterback Williams trying to throw the ball. They had hung back. Looks like they had read that all the way.
55 seconds to play third quarter, and if Florida State could get in the end zone in a relatively short period of time, you might have yourself a football game. Third down and 5, and if Florida State is to have any chance whatsoever, they must convert on third down and 5. Back goes Williams. He's rushed. He's hit. He's dropped back to the 34-yard line. Michael Woods, Dan Short on a safety blitz, number 29, coming in from the strong safety. Once again, the blitzes work well for Pitt, and Ron Stark will be called upon again.
And you have to give some credit to the defensive backfield there because they covered. He did have some time initially to throw, and when you're blitzing a defensive back, cornerback or safety, whatever, that means you're going to put some pressure on the guys who stay back there to guard against the pass, and obviously nobody was open right away because he ate it, took a big loss.
Here's Stark. There's a rush on. Ball's high. Flynn takes it at his own 12, looks for the wall, gets to the 20, hit at the 20 and out to the 23-yard line, and that's where Pitt will take over the football as the third quarter comes to an end. So, we have played three quarters of football here at the University of Pittsburgh, and the score at the end of three periods, Pitt 35, Florida State 14. Pitt with the football as we begin the fourth quarter after the punt by Ron Stark. Pitt at their own 23-yard line, and all they really have to do at this point is to hang on to that football. Marino with a gift to deep Bartolo, the fullback. It's a good game across the 25 and out near the 30-yard line. Ron Hester, inside linebacker, number 83, making the tackle. He had help from John McClain, defensive end.
That's another thing that Marino has done well. He has mixed up his passing enough where he hasn't been predictable. He's swung it out, he's thrown screens, he's thrown to the tight end, he's used all his receivers.
Second down and 9 yards to go. I backfield. Here's a give to the tailback. Busting across and out to the 30-yard line. Brian Thomas getting some of the penalty yardage back. It'll still bring up third down and 3 yards to go. Today's attendance, John, 55,112, which is just shy of a sellout here at Pitt Stadium, and the largest crowd since 1978 when the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame was here, opening up that 1978 season, which is also the last time that Pitt has lost at home. This will be, if they win today, their 18th consecutive victory at home, their 12th victory in a row overall.
It's the best game in the country this week.
Third down, give to Thomas, looks for a hole, 30, 35, out to the 41-yard line. Flag down, it'll be unnecessary roughness on Florida State. Brian Thomas making a 13-yard gain out of nothing getting the first down, Pitt will get an additional 15 yards, and that'll move them into Florida State territory. Good run by Brian Thomas.
Brian Thomas last week emerged as the tailback, and every time he carries the ball, he keeps solidifying his position, it seems to me, as the tailback for this team. He has great second effort, and that's exactly what Jackie Sherrill's been looking for, somebody to go with DeBartola. He knew he had the power back in DeBartola for the short yardage stuff. He knew he had the receivers. He knew he had the quarterback in the offensive line. The big question was the tailback, and that question has been answered in the last couple of weeks by Brian Thomas.
Brian Thomas now over 125 yards on the afternoon. This has got to be his personal best of all time. First down and 10, Pitt. The ball at the 43-yard line of Florida State. Marino with a play fake. He's rushed. He escapes the first rush, fires to DeBartola, escapes a tackler, looks for a block, fumbles the football, rolling loose, and I believe Florida State has recovered the football. Wayne DeBartola with his second fumble of the afternoon after he'd done a good job eluding tacklers will give Florida State the football. Now, John, we talked about turnovers, but at least this one is deep down in Florida State territory.
Yeah, DeBartola's had trouble holding onto the ball today. He's had caught a few of these passes. Marino does a good job, again, of stepping up out of the pocket and avoiding the rush. He's done that about three times, and all three times they've been to DeBartola, and twice on those three plays he's fumbled the ball, but maybe he's not used to being so wide open on being out in open field. He's used to running in traffic.
Tommy Young was the man who stripped him of the football, causing him to drop it, and now Florida State with the football at their own 28-yard line. High backfield. Williams, fake draw, rush out again by Woods, scrambles out of the pocket, hit and drop. Bill Maz came in from right defensive tackle. Dropped him for the sack, all the way back at the 18-yard line for a 10-yard loss. Does a good job eluding Michael Woods, but Maz got the penetration.
Well, if it's not one guy, it's another. And when you got penetration by everybody, eventually, if one guy's chasing, another guy's going to run into him. And they got a flag on Woods for, or is it Dolman?
Dolman.
For roughing the passer, or unnecessary roughness, either one. It's 15 yards.
And he was down on the ground. And even though he didn't hit him that hard, that is what you call unnecessary roughness. So Florida State, with a 10-yard loss and a sack, turns it into a first down with a penalty at the 34-yard line.
Florida State has, although it's just about out of hand now, they've gotten a lot of breaks on penalties and turnovers and just haven't been able to take advantage of it.
Pitch back to the tailback, but not this time, as the Pitt defense upset by the call. Ricky Williams is hit and dropped for a yard loss by Phil Pozzoli, coming from left defensive tackle.
Bill Moss coming out of the game there. Moss is another one. He's only a sophomore, 6'4", 259 pounds. And as well as this defense is playing this year, how good are they going to be next year?
Second down and six, even though there was a loss, the 15-yard penalty, John, was a dead ball foul, so it applies to the initial series. Here's a delayed draw to Whiting, gets it out to the 35, 36-yard line. That'll ring up third down and three, but again, Florida State is down here, 35 to 14, 12 minutes to play in a football game. You've got to be throwing it up.
I think they got to go for it, no matter who your punter is. You got to keep the ball. Now we're down to 11 minutes and 56 seconds to go in the game. And I would think that Florida State is going to go for it. He's staying in.
So it is third down, 2 yards to go.
Bobby Bowden wants a timeout.
And he doesn't like what's going on here. I think he wants to make sure. The yard marker, John, says fourth down. The scoreboard says third. And I believe it is third down because, again, the dead ball foul brought it up. Now let's see what happens. That's what Bowden called timeout for. He wants to know, hey, is it third down or fourth down? I think you've got to go for it either way, but he wants to make sure. Scoreboard, third down and two, as you see there. But again, yeah, the down marker on the sideline, as I mentioned earlier, does say fourth. Bowden saw the down marker. He thought it was third, and apparently it is fourth because they're sending the punting unit out of the game.
That's interesting. That is, if it is fourth down, and it's interesting that he's not going for it. I guess he's got to figure that if he punts it deep, maybe he can get a pit deep in their hole and make them punt out, and he won't lose that much time and score a quick touchdown. He's still got some time left, but to the point now when you're down by three touchdowns, you got to go for something.
Well, you have to wonder about the play calls also on that series. Only time he passed was on first down when he got sacked on the play. Here's the snap to Stark. Gets off a high kick. Flynn calls for fair catch at his own 18-yard line. That's where he'll take it, about the 19. So Flynn handles the punt flawlessly. And with 11:34 to play in the football game, Pitt again will take it on offense. And you really do have to question not only the play calls in that particular series, but also on fourth and two. The major thing is, probably the worst thing for Florida State was Bowden even seeing that it was fourth down. Sometimes ignorance is bliss. Time on the field. Pitt leads Florida State 35-14. Half yard. We'll call it second down and 9 yards to go. Thomas, the leading rusher in this football game.
Thomas ran into his blocker there, Bill Frelick, who was knocked back.
Next week, Pitt will host Syracuse, while Florida State continues its Oktoberfest, and it's been a successful one for them. They lost to Nebraska, but came back to beat Ohio State and Notre Dame on the road. This one on the road, looks like they'll lose to Pitt next week. They finally end the road trip. They play at LSU in Baton Rouge, and then they come home after being on the road for 49 days. Second down, 9 to go. Marino play fake, looking to throw. Fires over the middle. It is almost intercepted. Pass almost intercepted by James Harris, number 33, and he may have had a touchdown had he been able to hang on to the football.
Marino's got a great arm and a strong arm, and he's obviously not having any problems with his shoulder today. He threw that ball hard, but it's another case of a forced pass, I think. That's a ball either. He had plenty of time, and Florida State was doing a good job of covering receivers, and he should have just thrown that one away. He almost gave up a touchdown he wouldn't have to give up. He doesn't have to right now. He can throw the ball up into row L with a 35-14 lead and not worry about it.
Good stats of the day for Marino. Blitzes on from the outside. Marino fires deep, way downfield. A little bit of bumping going on. Almost intercepted by Harvey Clayton. Pass intended for Dwight Collins. Now the Pitt fans want interference. I don't think it existed. But in any event, the deep bomb is incomplete. That brings up fourth down and 9 yards to go.
Well, that's the man that he likes to throw to when he goes deep. But Dwight Collins is a state sprinting champion. He's also an all-state basketball player. And ball was just overthrown. I think they just ruled it was incidental bumping.
Cedric Jones takes the punt. And I'll tell you what, the officials, if they're on the ball, should call Pitt for 12 men on the field, because Dwight Collins did not get off the field in time. They snapped the ball very quickly. Collins was still at the hash mark when the ball was snapped. But they don't call anything. They probably just didn't see it. Pitt should have been called for that. Jones returns the football, and Florida State is in good position. Their own 49 near the 50-yard line. First down and 10. Well, maybe that's what Bobby Bowden had in mind. He only lost a minute and 50 seconds on the clock and gets the ball in better field position. But again, they are 3 touchdowns away from tying the game. Williams out in the flat. Pass is complete, but for a 2-yard gain. Not much doing there. Pass complete to tailback Ricky Williams. 2-yard gain. Kranak, number 55, the linebacker, on the tackle. Will be second down and 8 yards to go.
Here it is again. What Pitt wants to do is keep the score as one-sided as they can. Winning is one thing, but you got to impress the people who vote. There's Kranak coming up to make the play. Pitt 35-21 is not going to... People who saw the game are going to know that maybe Pitt dominated the game a little bit more than that, but somebody in Dubuque, Iowa, voting for the top 10 teams in the country may not be aware of that.
Williams snowed under again. Again, Pitt coming on a safety blitz with Dan Short, and they are just firing linebackers, and they are firing safeties. And, of course, with the game semi-out of hand, Stockstill is a guy who probably can read that a bit better than Blair Williams.
Well, Blair Williams is getting a good little workout today. He's going to be around next year, and this is some good experience for him because he's playing against the best defense in the country. And Williams has done a good job, too. I think we should give him some credit. Rick Stockstill, who would have thought that Stockstill would have been out of the game in the second quarter?
Third down and about 17 yards to go. Once again, the rush is on. Here's a screen in the middle. The Childers wide open. 50, 45, down to the 40, and down to the Pitt 39-yard line. Middle screen to the tight end. Ray Leo finally brought him down, but this time Williams read the blitz coming and found the tight end in the middle screen.
They got some backup people in there, too, and when you're getting the kind of pressure that Pitt has been putting on, then the thing you do is try to come back with a screen, and he is wide open as he catches the pass, and it's a good call. Although now it's getting late, 8:53 to go, 35-14, Pitt leading. It's all over except for the final score, you would think, and Pitt solidified their position as the number 3 team in the country.
First down, 10 yards to go. Florida State inside the Pitt 40-yard line. Here's a pitch wide to Williams. Got some blocking. 35, 30, and down to the 27-yard line. Ricky Williams with a 12-yard gain and a first down for Florida State. Troy Hill in at cornerback to make the tackle. So the Seminoles moving the ball a bit, but again, not much time left to go in the football game. 8:25, and the clock is rolling. Pitt on top by a score of 35 to 14. Now those people out in Dubuque, Iowa, can turn on the USA Network and see what happened in this football game if Florida State should make it close. 12-yard gain for Williams, first down and 10. 37 yards for Williams, but again, remember, 135 against Notre Dame. Here's that reverse coming once again. Cedric Jones with the football, waits for a block, and his hit hard at the 25, but gets forward to the 22, and a good bit of running by Cedric Jones. Rich Kranak came up and put a real lick on him, but he managed to survive that and get forward for five more, make it second down and 5 yards to go. They've used this play on several occasions, and Jones obviously has the option whether he would like to run or pass. He took a look, saw that he had a run, and coming up, Kranak, Troy Hill, but a 5 yard gain. Second down and 5 yards to go. Clock running now, 7.5 to play. Pitch wide, Ricky Williams looks for a block, tries to get outside, gets to the 21-yard line. Stop for a gain of one, it'll be third down. Pat McQuaid coming up as Jackie Sherrill begins to insert some second team defensive members. Primarily, it is still the first unit in there. It'll be third down, 4 yards to go for Florida State. First down. Pitt really put this game away early in the third quarter. They scored two touchdowns in the first 2.5 minutes of the third quarter after taking a 21-7 lead at the half. But they came out a 65-yard touchdown pass to Dawkins, made it 28-7. A recovered fumble and another touchdown pass. Marino's third made it 28-7. From that timeout, it's been pretty much all Pitt. Here's the give inside to the 20-yard line to Ricky Williams. He'll be shy of that first down, and it'll be fourth down and three, and quite obviously, Florida State must go for the touchdown, the first down. Field goal does them no good whatsoever. Running out of the pro set backfield. Just a quick inside handoff, straight dive, and a good job by Michael Woods, who made initial contact before he got to the line of scrimmage. And Williams now with 41 yards and 15 carries. Fourth down and three, perhaps the last hurrah for Florida State if they are to get on the board. Fourth down, 3 yards to go. Williams firing out in the flat to Whiting. Got room, 20, down to the 16-yard line, and very close to the first down, he's got it. It'll be a gain of 5 yards and a first down for Florida State at the Pitt 16-yard line. So Florida State maintains possession of the football with 6 minutes to play in the football game. Plays being run in by the wide receivers. Phil Williams, who has had a good day this afternoon. He's a senior. Came into the football game with 9 catches for a good average of 19.3. He did catch one pass for 38 yards. Blair Williams coming in relief in the second quarter of starter Rick Stock, still 7 out of 12. Play fake. He's firing deep in the corner of the end zone, and it is intercepted at the 5-yard line. Great play by Tim Lewis. They were looking to hit the tight end. Double coverage on the play. Lewis saw it all the way. Playing center field back there. Came across to pick it off. Watch it again. Williams thought he had a man open. Had time. Looking in the corner for what could have been a touchdown for Childers, but a great play by Lewis, who read it all the way. Pass intended for tight end Childers. Lewis with the interception, and Pitt takes over first and goal, or first down and 10, at their own 5-yard line. First interception today. Pitt in the eye. Marino still in there at quarterback. Brian Thomas looking for a hole right side. Gets out to the 10, and a nice gain on first down. Gets out of bounds. Stops the clock, which he didn't necessarily want to do, but he'll take that 5 yards. 5:32 to play in a football game. Harris knocking him out of bounds. There you see Tim Lewis, who made the interception. Junior, 6 feet, 190 pounds. And again, one of those Pitt players who had talent last year, but was playing behind some of the people who really stocked the NFL draft. Pitt had 12 players taken in the NFL draft last year, to give you an idea of what kind of football team they had last year. Their only loss coming to Florida State. Pitch wide once again to Thomas. Got some room. First down. 20, 25. He needs a block. Gets outside. 35. Out to the 40. Across midfield. The 45, the 30, and down to the 25-yard line. of Florida State. Brian Thomas reeling off a run all the way from his 11-yard line, and they spot the ball at the Florida State 26. 53-yard run by Brian Thomas. He's pushing 200 yards. Needed the block on the outside. He got it. Now uses Julius Dawkins as his blocker. Hits the midfield stripe, and it's a race down the sideline. They had the angle on him. Cuts back in beautifully. That gives him another 10 yards. And now 165 yards for Brian Thomas. And what a day he has had. DeBartolo, the fullback, hit at the line of scrimmage, gets inside the 25 to the 24, gain of a couple. It'll be second down and 8 yards to go. Dan Marino with three touchdown passes this afternoon. May have to take a back seat and star of the game to Brian Thomas with 165 yards rushing. Making 185, a recalculation. So he is near that 200-yard mark. 185 yards. And 121 of those yards have come here in the second half. He had 60-plus in the first 30 minutes of football. Second down and eight, Pitt at the Florida State 24-yard line. Joe McCall, big hole up the middle. Inside the 20 and down to the 17-yard line. So Pitt beginning to chew him up. Well, I suppose it depends upon who your mathematician may be, but now we're told that Thomas has 200 yards on 20 carries. 10 yards per carry. You take half that. So there is a timeout on the field. 3:19 to play in the football game. Pitt well in control as they lead Florida State 35-14. Pitt gunning for another national championship. Their last one 5 years ago with Tony Dorsett and company. Fourth down, a foot to go at the 16-yard line. Give to Thomas. He's got the first down inside the 15 and near the 14-yard line. So Brian Thomas dives over left tackle for the first down. That'll give him 202 yards in 21 carries. Hurt his average a bit, but at this juncture, who cares? 3:15 to play. Pitt will win its fifth. Florida State's record will drop to 4-2. Florida State not out of the woods yet, however, and certainly not out of the bowl picture either. They have a chance to make it up, what with Southern Mississippi, LSU, and Miami of Florida still on their schedule. First down and 10, Pitt at the 14-yard line. Ryan Thomas, he's to the 10, he's to the 5, and near a first down inside the 5-yard line, close to that 4. Another 10 yards for Ryan Thomas, gives him 211. Jarvis Corson makes the tackle. Gain of 9, second down, 1 yard to go for the first down, 5.5 for the touchdown. Clock rolling, 2.5 minutes to play in this football game. Bobby Bowden, in the middle of his Oktoberfest, will go home. Not really a bad job with a split, losing at Nebraska and Pitt, winning at Ohio State and Notre Dame. Second down one, Thomas again, hit at the 5, touchdown Pitt. Brian Thomas going wild. 5 yard touchdown run. Pitt is on the board again, making it 41-14 with the conversion attempt coming up next. What an afternoon for that young man, who played hardly at all in the first three games of the year. Last week against West Virginia, had 2 touchdowns, scoring both Pitt touchdowns, and rushing for 97 yards. And as he emerged as a star, hit at the 5, breaks loose, good block. Up front, thrown by Jim Sweeney, the right guard. Kick by Everett is good. And Pitt now finishes it off with a 42-14 lead. 2:14 to play. So, 2:14 to play. Pitt remains undefeated. We'll be back. Pitt 42, Florida State 14.
Set special C and anchor detail.
Right standard runner.
Right standard runner, right.
Port of call, Hong Kong.
Sir, combat hold.
The Navy. Over 75% of our jobs give you technical training. Get one.
Let go of the anchor.
Liberty call now, Liberty call.
Speak to your recruiter or call this toll-free number. Navy, it's not just a job, it's an adventure.
Oh.
Eric Schubert, who may have to have his leg packed in ice, will kick off once again for Pitt. Greg Allen back deep to receive the kick. A winding kick down to the 2-yard line. Lewis Allen fumbles the football, picks it up, gets to the 10. They'll get out to the 14-yard line. That's it. That may have symbolized Florida State's efforts here this afternoon. Taking a look at Brian Thomas's touchdown. It's just good hard running. Gets a good block to Sweeney, number 53, pulling on the play. DeBartolo seals off. There you see the block by DeBartolo, 31. Sweeney's 53. Thomas eludes one tackle, gets to the outside, and he's in for the touchdown. His second of the afternoon, rushing for nearly 210 yards. So first down, 10, Florida State at their own 14, 2:08 to play in the football game. At this point, it's not how or who, but rather by how much. Give inside, a big run to the outside for Florida State. Picking up the football was Don Davis. It'll be a gain across the 20 and out to the 23-yard line. Second down and 1 yard to go. Pitt has held Florida State just 59 yards net rushing. And that falls in line with their number one ranking again. Pitt had given up only 14 yards net rushing in the first four games of the season. Williams to Billy Allen. He gets across the 25, out across the 30, and for a first down near the 32-yard line. Be good for a Florida State first down. Billy Allen is a rather interesting story. He's a freshman, but he was in the Air Force. Bobby Bowden recruited him in London, England. He was in the Air Force playing football over there, and he's 22 years old and a freshman. Has not played because he has had some fumbleitis, but he's in there now. Second down. Williams throws, and it is complete up at the 45-yard line and out to the 48-yard line to Tony Johnson. That'll be good for another Florida State first down at their own 48. Clock stops, of course, in the first down with 1:09 to play in the football game, but the issue has indeed been decided with Pitt leading 42-14. That will raise some eyebrows around the country. Hard to say there's a key play in a football game when it's 42-14, but Florida State, with the first opportunity to score, fourth down and a foot at the 1-yard line, they did not make it. Pitt then went on a 99-yard drive, aided on a roughing the kicker penalty. Third down, little flat pass to Billy Allen, a 50, down to the Pitt 47. It'll be a gain of 5 and bring up fourth down and 5. So it's fourth down and 5 now. Williams will throw. Here comes the Pitt rush. He fires over the middle. And it is caught at the 37-yard line by Phil Williams. That'll be good for a first down. It'll also stop the clock now with 17 seconds to play. They'll start it again as soon as the yard markers are placed correctly. 42-14. Pitt on top as Florida State hopes to salvage something by getting into the end zone one more time. Here's Williams, blitzed, he's hit, he fires and thrown, it's intercepted. And all the way back to near the 40-yard line is middle guard, or rather defensive end Johnson. Williams trying to make something out of absolutely nothing. He is hit again, hit blitzing on the play. Al Wenglikowski coming in on the blitz. Johnson makes the interception. He was surprised to get the football at the 39-yard line. 3 seconds to play in the football game, and Pitt will run one play, and it'll be lights out on Florida State, at least for this Saturday afternoon. Power eye to the left. Dan Daniels, reserve quarterback, takes the football and falls down, and Pitt has won its fifth straight. Florida State will go home 4-2. Bobby Bowden shaking hands with Dan Marino at the middle of the field. Pappy Thomas in there as Bowden looks for Jackie Sherrill, being carried off in one of the biggest games at Pitt Stadium in recent years for the University of Pittsburgh. Oh,